There's Ben Woolerton, the man in control this afternoon, supported by Chloe Sampson and Caitlin Bates. Very experienced television match official in Aaron Patterson. Six rounds building to a grand final. As Super Rugby Aupiki continues to evolve. It is the beaten finalists of 2023 against the always double tough team based out of our nation's capital. All is in readiness. So glad you're with us.
Come on. Holding.
Rennie Holmes gets us underway. Beautifully placed kick as well. Straight away, Baker with their hands on the ball. Lush. You get wide to King. Really good Manawa too. Loose forward combo for the Poua. King wanting to get this wide. And away with some space already. It grew up to halfway. Good grass. And tackle needed to be made. Great start from the Poua. Big run. Big tackle as well. Great start from the visitors though. Looking for space, trying to get through. There's King again on the carry. Lush. Switch again, but it says they go wide. It's a good tackle. It needed to be on Waterman. No chance for the Manawa to get their defensive line set. Little kick into space. Awkward bounce. Well taken. Stymies. Great hands. Tui, kick and chase. The track back is Waterman. Tui chasing. That's a beautiful kick. And all Isabella Waterman can do is fine touch. Net gain for the Chiefs, but what an opening 90 seconds.
A good fiery start from both sides. You see the intention from the kickoff to go short. Try and get Ruby Tui involved in the game, but the Hurricanes Poua, they maintain that decision, their position, managed to pull a few really good phases together, specifically Monica Tongawa'i finding some space out wide. Now, a good opportunity here for the Manawa.
Just target in the middle. Brenda pulls it down and they drive on her. And this is very much the Luca Connor zone. The Manawa look to try and drive. This is nicely set, fracturing the Poua defence. Still there and driving. Can they stop her? They get her and finally drag her back.
Holding.
Kenwood standing was waiting. That's Colonna Valley. Tanya going low, they managed to repel. That's good goal line defence. Short ball, driving again. Bremner having taken the line out, she goes. This is good defence once again. Wide they look to go, simple. Bit of an errant pass, scooped up nicely by Holmes. Steinmetz wrapping round, quick hand to the outside, Paul. Tongawaiti tries to get over the top. That was a great spot tackle by Baker. Great work. There's that centre combination for the Poua, getting them out of dodge.
Once again, it's Monica Tongawaiti over that ball. And this time last year, you would have thought that from that very tidy set piece that the Manawa would have been in for all money. That's really their bread and butter. You saw Luca Connor break off from the driving maul and almost carry two players back. But there's good defensive efforts on the line there from the Hurricanes Poua. Remember, 10 new debutants in this team. Five in the starting lineup. Mererangi Paul looked after well there from Shakira Baker and Tongawaiti over top.
Stay there, just stay there.
Christo Taufua to throw. Yeah. Is Christo Taufa. Married recently, under the married name.
That's fine.
Nice ball at the front as well.
Yeah,
there's Lakato bringing it down.
Yeah.
Trying to get the hands on there. Is this going to come out? It's not. The Manawa force a turnover. As I said, I was just literally licking my lips when you look at the quality in the second row. Chelsea Bremner, Sian Main Smith, Jackie Patia Ferret, Rachel Rakato. That's just quality, quality second row forwards.
Like pretty much
first real error there too for the Poua. We're looking to find some cohesion and set piece. And they've got a big scrum to defend here.
Many it only Paul directly behind Simple as Hinwood, Connor and company get ready to go to work. Able to hook the ball. Is that a tight head? That's an old school tight head. Lush gets the ball away. And a chance for the Poua to work their way out. And they're going to be piggybacked with a penalty as well. Oh, my goodness. James Parsons is somewhere loving seeing an old school tight head ball hooked back by the number two.
And that is huge for the Hurricanes Poua. We know that the Manawa came out of the 2023 season with all the stats. They dominated set piece specifically in that scrum area. When you look across that leading, that starting lineup, it's all Black Ferns. So huge motivation for them to get that scrum there, considering all the newbies that they've got in their team.
Mark's on here.
It's a very strong start. Yeah, let's see now whether they can get this line out ticking away.
Yeah, that's fine.
Numbers. The back line set. To the front, lots of movement. King down nicely. Lush looking to get wide. King. Oh, big shot. That's Anderson. On Tangawai. Nice quick hands. King again. And the time King involved early. And a King sees some space and just goes through. Support outside here. Still going. Away to Ferris. Oh, and she hands it back to Tui. Now has she got space the other way? Kick chase. Will that ball stay in? No, it won't. Oh, thought for all the world, honey. They were away there.
Oh, look at this. Slices through the middle of Anderson and Marino Taurinu there. Probably could have kept it in hand. Ruby Tui manages to get in the passing lane there. Gets her team out of trouble.
Thank you.
Looking really good is Hannah King. Remember, she's only 20 years old.
Lush away to the aforementioned Hannah King. Carry midfield from Leila Sutton. Lush again. Contact, set and go again. Looking with their face play at the moment. They drive, trying to hold them up. Anderson in there, yeah, so too Bremer. Why they come again? King. This time they manage to get it to the ground as she's squashed by Colonavale. Issa goes to the 10-metre mark. Oh, Manawa turned that one over. There was hands there. Luke Kakona comes up with it. Rennie Holmes, we know it's in her range if she so desires. Not too much of a breeze sideline. Oh, that's nice into the corner as well.
Chrissy there, good to see her back in our game. You see, great body positioning, gets on the ball first thing. Aolu Putia cannot move. Solid foundation of Luke O'Connor. Get this throw right here.
Beautifully taken down. Simple. Short ball charging. That's Saito, the Japanese international. And another turnover. Straight into Leila Saito.
There we go, seeing those one-on-one matches nice and early in the game. Saina Saito, her first carry of the ball. She goes straight into Leila Saito. We know that she is a sniper when it comes to those turnovers. Good to see Chelsea Semple there back in the 10 jersey. Look at this, she gets her body straight around there, straight on that ball.
Game being played at place, but Issa out in midfield setting the target. Lush gets there quickly. Wide they come again. King. Baker wanting to get to the outside. Steinmetz drags her to the ground. Still just working from outside their own 22. King combining. And Parisset runs headlong into Smith. Who manages to get some go forward though. Watch again. Now they're going to put this on the boot. Nice bounce. Favourable. Good territory gained there by the Hurricanes. Poua.
Isabel Waterman there, just showing her experience, holding her composure. Beautiful kick.
Hannah King, who's been so prominent. Such a young 9-10 combination. Paige Lusher, real standout for Manawa 2 in the Parapama Cup last year. It's a little bit messy. Ball has been knocked on by Kalfua. Here comes Manino Tahino. Ball slapped down. Smuggle this ball back. Tahino. Over the top. And that's going to be the opening try of Super Rugby Aupiki. And it's going to be scored by Azalea Maka. Manawa up by 5 after 10. The defence had been so solid, Honey, that looked to me like one of the first real missed tackles of the game almost.
And they've managed to hold the Manawa out for 10 minutes. But look at the work here. Initially came off Marina Tohunu, who made that initial break. But Mia Anderson here, she gets through, evades the last defender, pop over the top. And who better to find than Marker on the edge there to get the scoring try for the Chiefs Manawa.
Yep, nice smiles. It's been a very entertaining opening 11 minutes. Now, Rennie Holmes. Ball has come off the tee. So that'll be her. It's time, remembering, if you watched Italy-France, you'll be very familiar with the rules with regards to that. Still got to re-tee it within the time. Steps, strikes. Delightful. Never looked like missing. Full allotment for the Manawa. Let's head down sideline. Liz Elder. Heck of an opening 12 minutes, Liz.
It was. I've just been sitting here back and forth, enduring that excitement. But I'm impressed by this Poua team. They have come out, they've controlled some set-piece action, they are controlling their ball and retaining their ball at the ruck. And while the Manawa happened to get a try there, this Poua has got some exciting look to them.
You don't knock over the defending champs, and people go, oh, it's only pre-season. Poua, I tell you straight away, is there's an error off the kickoff by the Manawa, and those are the things that coaches don't like. They beat Matatu last week, 34-33. And it's pre-season. Look, it's a big, big moment for the Poua. Just gives them that confidence rolling into the season proper. Different teams take different things out of pre-season games, and I'm sure a lot of confidence would have been gained with that victory in Christchurch last week.
I do like what the Poua are doing with ball in hand, especially with such a young 9 and 10 combination, but they look like they're really confident. They're willing to chance their arm, throw the ball around. They're linking with the forwards really well, so let's see them sort the set piece out.
Poua looking for the target. They find it nicely. And Rakatau. And this is under advantage. They've got an opportunity to take a shot here if they want. Sutty waits. Runs headlong, runs over Semple. Lush looking. Wide it comes. Poua. Only metres to go. Wide they come again. Patea Fenerty gets the step going. Lovely tackle, Simon. It can go once again. Wonderful defence. That's Bremner. They got it held up. Can they cycle it back? Yes, they can. They'll get another shot. This is still all under advantage for the Poua. Trying to strike back immediately. Low body. Are they there? Yes, they are. And just like that, I'll tell you what, that young lady deserves it as well. Eleanor Plumking has been very active in the opening 14. 7-5 with a kick to come.
Well, how good for Eleanor Plumking. Score on debut. Just the confidence to keep the ball in hand there and have another crack at a line. It came off multiple phases and a really strong set piece. But Les, you must be impressed with these debutants really rolling up their sleeves and getting into that tough grind.
I am 100%, and that girl right there, number six, Eleanor Plumking, has had multiple touches early in the stages of this game. She deserved that one. I spoke to Rihanna Ferris earlier in the week, and she said, King's words, she's fizzing and ready to unleash, and she's doing exactly that.
Nice kick from Waterman. Levels it all up. I guess the great thing in as well, that there's just no fear. Someone would go, oh, it's a step up to the super level. Well, Eleanor Blum, she's just happy as a clam and just going about her work as per normal.
Well, she runs straight into Blackburn and Luke O'Connor to take on that line. So that shows the confidence level there. But also the hard work that she's done off the field, product of the Manukura school.
They know how to produce rugby players. There's Baker carrying. Nice opening 15 minutes to the season. There she is again, King. Lush. Back to Hannah King. Little one slid off the side. Stays in. The kick she would have wanted, but it's ended up okay. She's Hannah King. That's a very good Canterbury system. Player who's moved to get some playing time at Super Rugby Aupiki 2024. Front, beautiful take, fire down, simple again. They go, Steinmetz drilled. Tangawai did not miss. Marina Tahinu wide. Smith, Connor, simple. Out it goes. Simon down the left wing. That's delightful rugby. And an instant strike back from the home side.
Once again, we see the slick skills of the Chiefs' Manawa coming to fruition. And how good to see Chelsea Semple there. Loops around the back there. Gets a really good ball here from Luke O'Connor. She fakes the inside to Ruby Tui. But who's on the outside? It's captain of the Blackburns, Kennedy Simon. No one's stopping her.
Just some simple draw and pass, and then the work rate from Semple and Tui to get around on the outside. Kennedy only had to catch and run.
A good career option as well, giving it to the Blackburns captain. That's a nice strike. Got to say as well, little credit to Grace Steinmetz, because she got drilled, ribcage rearranged, yet still had the wherewithal to be able to place, and that very much helped coming to back to this left-hand side, honey.
Oh, you do not run into Monica Tangwai's shoulders. She featured on Smashed and Broke a number of times last year, and no doubt she'll be on this week again.
Holmes, after that very good initial strike, that one of these just dragged away to the left. Unconverted, 12-7. Good quality start from both sides. There's Kennedy Simon, the Black Ferns captain. Co-captain, I should say. Don't get in trouble with Rua Haidemann. Start by Waterman. And the Manawa exit a little bit better than what they did last time. There's Tangawai again on the tackle, taking down Paul. Tauhino away to Simple. Nice angled run there. Presented nicely. That was Anderson. Swept away left once again. Kalonavale. Little quick balls, got to go back and get it. There's Plumking, Eleanor Plumking again in the mix.
No advantage, not gone goal.
Gone there. My goodness, Eleanor Plumking is everywhere at the moment.
You got to take your head off to Grace Steinmetz too there in number 12. She's taken a fair few beatings. Remember, shifted into the 12. Usually used to seeing her out on the wings because she's got pace to boom, but how good is she standing up in the midfield right now?
View there of the defensive line.
No.
The possible attacking line. We know that
need more space.
Crystal Kawa, the coach of the Manawa, likes to play the game in a positive fashion. Semple to the left, Steinmetz to the right, Mucker outside of her. There's Chelsea. Weighing up the options.
Bynes! Sit! To the back of play.
What's going on, Ruby Tui trying to get to the outside. Great fence! She's got some space. Defense coming across. Wants to go inside out. Nice work by Anderson. Trying to stay in play. Can't though.
No foul.
I'm a little surprised there, honey, for a lady who likes the kick and chase. Wonder whether maybe Ruby missed a trick there.
Oh, so elusive though. Look at this. Footwork in and out. Leaves Sturmey for dust. Probably shouldn't use the kick there though. How good to see Ruby back in the Chiefs Manawa jersey, lighting up those fringes.
The crowd definitely got up when Ruby got the ball. They're all here for to see Ruby play.
Yeah, one of the global stars of the game, that is for sure, Ruby Tui. Back, and Connor's trying to get to that one, but swooped on by Hannah King.
No.
Enough to be a little disruptive. King goes in and plays halfback this time. Nice carry by the captain. Just looking to go nice and straight. Rush. King sees a little space in behind. Semple beautifully positioned though. So the option, nice fend. Looking. Is he going to find some space? Yes, it is. Gets a great bounce. Gets a wonderful bounce. Waterman in trouble. Oh, great work by Isabella. Dragged to the ground by Semple. He just shrugged off Merirangi Paul. This is messy though. Chiefs Manawa have got bodies there. And they force the knock on. Good kick chase. Gets some reward for the home side.
It's beautiful attacking play from the Chiefs Manawa and really starting with Chelsea Semple there. Saw her weighing up her options, running across field. It's a beautiful kick down. Waterman there to clean up as well to get rid of Merirangi Paul. But straight away, Chelsea Semple chases her own kick, brings her down, and now they're in prime position.
Good attacking opportunity here. The Hurricanes, Poua, they have shown how to be competitive at scrum time. So some work for Henwood, Connor Vale and company to try and get a nice platform for the backs to strike off. Nice strike by Connor to start.
Use it.
Yeah, Tauhinu, Semple, short ball, Mucker. Nice tackle by King. Wide it comes again, Steinmetz, Semple. Hand in there. This has been knocked down and under advantage. Poua drive through. They'll play the knock on. Another opportunity this time to attack from the left-hand side of the uprights. Halfway through the first half. Good opening to Super Rugby Aupiki.
There's plenty going on, isn't there? And you can see all these players have come into the season. First game. Had the pleasure of watching the next game with Matatu and the Blues up next down in Invercargill Rugby Park. What a great welcome from the local school down there.
Looking forward to that Blues combination of Cottrell and Demant at 10 and 12. I like the idea of Ruhe wearing that 12 jersey. She's a great 10, don't get me wrong. She could really cause some mischief. Another spot out. Wide pass. Wild was probably more at. Mucker's got to tidy this one up. Centerfield platform wide, it comes against Steinmetz, fend, and away to Paul, who can't haul it in.
Knock on.
Oh, there was another opportunity. That one's gone a big and a little bit.
Yeah, a couple of missed opportunities there. Ball just not quite going to hand. But I like what Steinmetz is doing there. She's really embracing the 12 jersey, trying to create space for her outsides.
Can you try and quantify how big a shift it is from wing to second five? Is that possible to put into words?
Yeah, huge. Look, I never really made it that far in the field because it's just too much hard work defensively. But look, you know, you've got to be strong and robust to shift into that 12 jersey. It's a high demand position, and I think so far, this opening 25 minutes, she's really putting her name on that 12 jersey.
A high read, high communication position as well, isn't it? You've really got to be talking and onto it. Great scrum. Good contest at scrum time. Off the back it comes. There's Tangawai just gliding through. Up to Temple. They drag it down, pops the ball, and Saito tracking back. It falls nicely for the Japanese international. Wide it comes to Simon. She looks to glide through. Now to Smith. Semple again flicks that one on. Ball ping-ponging around. Sits nicely for the Manawa on their 10-metre mark. Semple again trying to get to the outside to Ruby Tui. Gets the fend going. Foot was in touch. This is Chloe Sampson.
Once again, Monica Tangawai just fend, slices straight through. It's been really hard to handle this opening half. Look at it, huge, strong fend, so powerful.
Looks like she's keen for another opportunity to run as well.
I think just an observation from the sideline. Poua definitely taking their time at lineouts, maybe a tactic to regain some breath in this fast momentum game.
Also, Ben Bulletin saying you can't complain about the gap, so clearly there is a little bit going on there. Stolen, Manawa, Henwood carries and presents. Steinmetz flips that ball out. Holmes, quick hands, Merirangi Paul. Little chip over the top. Nicely taken, coming forward by Waterman. Sliced down by her opposite. She pops the ball up. Guess who again? Strong carry. Chiefs trying to counter, blowing over the top. Ball bouncing around. There's Kotai coming in off the wing to help out. And another penalty for the home side. Picking going, Marina Tauhidu, Steinmetz, dragged down, looks to present. Saito pops the ball to Semple, Connor away to Anderson. Thought better of popping that ball, rolls and presents nicely. Comes back, they've got advantage here. Surely it's just numbers, Henwoods, Kennedy's got a double. The skipper runs in. Takes the advantage up to 10 with 27 and a half minutes gone here in Kirikiriroa.
Well, the local fans are happy, and so they should be. And how impressive has the ball movement been from the Chiefs, Manawa? They're taking risk, and it is paying off. Look at this. They just want to keep shifting the ball, the small passes, the short passes. And then they look out here, they've got numbers for days. Once they clear that ball, long pass coming in there. Kate Henwood probably could have stepped over herself, but she hands it off to the captain and Kennedy Simon.
Hasn't been all pretty. There's been a lot of border ground and drop ball, but you can see their intention is to get that ball to the edges, at least let the wingers have a play down the flanks. They're just distributing that ball, getting it to space.
See the final act again, Henwood. Like all good tight forwards, not about the glory, just doing their job. Allowing Kennedy Simon to just canter in for one of the easiest tries of her career. Nice work as well by Simon to bring it around, make the kick easier for Rennie Holmes. Good start. And they find Paul this time, goes inside looking to straighten it up as Maka runs headlong into the defence. Yeah. Tauhinu. Box kick, that's nicely weighted. Coming forward. ball. Knocked on. Trying to get there was Merirangi Paul. We'll have another scrum.
Scrum call.
Or a line out option.
Knock on.
They decide to go with the forward.
Let's go back to my 30 seconds.
Hard skill to execute. You're running onto the ball like that. You know you've got a defender in there. She goes up for it anyway. Just shows the confidence that Merirangi Paul, World Rugby Breakthrough Player of the Year last year. Second on the top of the table for this Aupiki competition.
Crouch! Bones! Set!
Oh, halfbacks, you've got to love them. Ball sitting at the back for Sutton. Away it comes now to Lush again, wanting to get it to Tangawahi, who is just running at Semple and Steinmetz and having a whale of a time. Wide they look to come again. Nice fend by Sturmey. Lush. Ball at the feet. That's picked up beautifully by Rakatau. Losing ground though, the Poua. Wide it comes. Bit of space here. Ferris. Inside it goes to Sturmey. Now a little pop ball again. Lush inside ball. Messi knocked on. Manawa would grab it. Charmaine Smith was onto it. Double knock on. So they'll set another scrum. I think Liz Albert summed it up nicely. He's just got a little scrappy in the last 5 or so minutes. I guess maybe born a little bit out of confidence from that opening 25, which for the most part was pretty good in terms of skill execution.
Yeah, absolutely. Just a bit of disconnect there too between your backs and your forwards. Just lacking a bit of patience, need to take the ball to ground, recycle, build their phases. Ball in hand, they look really dangerous. Midfield seems to be finding some cracks in that Chiefs Manawa defence.
Bones! No.
Good attacking opportunity.
We've had space, and now we're fatigued and we've got no space, so we need to hold it, please.
Woolerton's had a little bit of work to do. Trying to sort out the space at line-out time. Now it's a little bit of scrum maintenance that he has to undertake. I see King, first receiver. That's Tangawai outside.
Bind!
And Mario Sturmey standing just behind Peter King in that alignment you just briefly saw. One penalty. Galonavale there earning the penalty. Aolopatia, Hawke's Bay captain, co-captain on debut, but brings a lot of experience. It's a nice kick. I suspect you may have just heard Ruby Tui's enjoyment of that particular kick coming through the wonderful Sky microphones.
Just for our viewers at home who can't see off camera, she is hyping her team up, constantly talking. She brings that kind of energy.
She just hypes life in general, doesn't she, Liz? She's one of those people. Ball is messy. And actually, the Poua have been able to turn this over. That's it. I'm trying to get over the top. Lush, King wide, Tangawai, Baker, Waterman. Trying to get to the outside of Maka. Drags it to the ground just short of halfway. Rangi Paul in there. Infringement though. Aulupatia on the carry and present. For Lush to sweep away. Here's the skipper. That's your Fetity. Rise that one back. Lush again. He's been clearing well. Little dab through. Tangawai. It sits up nicely inside. Ball King. Tackle needed to be made. Front foot ball though for the Hurricanes. Poua wants to slow it down a little bit. Away it comes to Sutton, the vice captain, and stepping away is Layla. Tackle needed to be made by Holmes. Getting over the top is Steinmetz. Grace has turned that one over, then back to Holmes, who's wrapped around in a position to clear. Oh, that's excellent work. First by Layla Sutty, then by Grace Steinmetz, and then again by Renee Holmes.
Look at the break there. Shrugs off the defence. It's well cleaned up there, though, from Renee Poua, Renee Holmes, who then gets herself back into position to give a beautiful clearing kick and get the Chiefs' Manawa out of trouble. So many one-on-one matchups here. Layla Sa'i is really such a huge threat in this Hurricanes Poua team.
It's something, Liz, you love to see, though. A player just getting up off the deck straight away, hustling to get back into position to make the next play. It's absolutely outstanding. Ball off the top. Wanted to come wide once again. Nope, they're going to keep it tight. And Sutty, great carry just short of halfway she's taken. Blindside come the ball. Rakato, that ball has been just flicked on by Olupatia. Going quickly here. Coming wide for Holmes. Bodies outside. Steinmetz trying to get to the outside. Shrugs off Baker. Little pop there for Holmes. Over the top to Tui. Yeah, it was a forward pass in there as things were starting to get spicy down the left for the home side.
You see the intention of the Chiefs Manawa to really want to play an expansive game. Size up options well. Get the ball wide. Keep the ball alive. Got offloads galore happening here, but unfortunately that one doesn't quite come off. The connection between Holmes and Ruby Tui there. But also good defence once again from the Hurricanes pole. They're making the Manawa really work. Once they get out wide in those channels, and we talked about double efforts, Shakira Baker there.
Five. Six.
Great deal with the scrum and the power.
Yeah, pull out.
Through Lush in a little bit of trouble. She tries to get herself out of strife. So he's got to go back and help clean up. Here comes away. There's Rihanna Ferris flung to the ground by Kalona Vale. Lush. Ooh, smashed. Then they're going to hold the Wheeler girl up. Well, Paige Lush now knows a little bit about Super Rugby. Aupiki, don't run into Charmaine Smith and Tanya Kolonovale at the same time. Try to avoid that for career longevity.
That's what you call sandwich in there. You are not coming out of that anytime soon. Kolonovale, great to see her working really hard, getting around the park defensively. She's been strong this half.
Good second row combination. I'll say this about Paige Lush, though. We saw it during, again, Arapama Cup last year. She's tough. Great young talent coming through in that nine jersey.
Working too hard for the balls, though.
Just speaking to Victoria Grant, Poua coach. They said
keep
that Lush was the third ranked halfback in Canterbury. They've identified her and brought her up Hurricanes territory. She's having a blinder so far.
They've done well. This recruitment is so key in a competition like this. There's a bit of space away to that blind side. There you see the back line alignment. There's a little bit of gap away to the blind side. There you see it. I want to try and isolate Ruby Tui against Maria Sturmi. It's a possibility. Need a good scrum to do so, and they get it. Held at the back, and they do want to come that way. And Otauhinu with the carry. Rolls and presents. They're going to need a halfback. Smith says, I'll play that role. Simple. Get a little bit of structure back here to the home side. It comes out to Bremner. Nice defense again by Sutton. Bonavale will look to carry. Rumble forward. Take some stopping. Good go forward. Can she get the quick ball? Needs to slow it down a little bit. Nice step by Kennedy Simon. Oh, had to hold on to it. As Ferris came over the top. Here's Rayana. Just on 60 seconds to go in this first half. Entertaining first half as well at FMG Stadium, Waikato. Opening game, Super Rugby Aupiki 2024. Very keenly contested. Kennedy really had no option there, did she, but to hold on.
And as we like to arrive here, Poua will get their last opportunity before we head into half-time.
King reaches high. Satan clung away. Here's Baker. Wanting to get to the outside. Shakira, a little ball there for Waterman. Great tackle again by Holmes, who's made some really good tackles stepping up from fullback. Baker up and going again. They're trying to wrestle Shakira to the ground. Lush. Inside ball. King. Still going. Eleanor Plum King gets the offload to the 22. Nice pop ball. Say. Say swerving. What a try. Great strike by the Poua right on half time.
Well, she absolutely deserves that, doesn't she? She's been everywhere in this opening half. Such a workhorse. Defensively, she's gutsy and fearless, but it's what she does with ball in hand. You can see here. They make the small break there. They recycle ball quickly. Tangawai with the offload. The step inside, simple. And she is over. Great try from Layla Sa'i.
I thought she missed
it. It's the double efforts. This girl here on screen, Eleanor Plum King. She carried. And then she's in the support line. And Layla Sa'i as well. The double efforts at these Lucy's from the Poua team. The work rate is outstanding.
I've seen great work rate from every player on the field so far. It's been a very industrious 41 minutes. Waterman converts despite the best intentions of Ruby Tui. And as we head to the break, the late strike brings the Poua back within five. Half time, it's Chiefs Manawa 19, Hurricanes Poua 14.
Tough first 40, what do you make of that?
Yeah, I mean, 15 days on the grass together and to come out in game one and I guess come up against a team like Poua today, they're really bringing it to us, I guess, around the set piece area. So for us, it's just sticking to our systems and staying together and connected to make sure that we come out in the second half together.
They're a bit of an unknown, this Poua team, but they seem to be targeting that 10-12 channel. What do you do to fix that?
I think our whole thing is be connected. So we lost a bit of that connection in the first half. So we've had a word to the girls and they know that they've got to go out there together this half.
Awesome. Bit of momentum sitting in the Poua field this going into the half. What's the plan straight out of the tunnel?
Like I said, I think just go back to our own systems. Stay in our system and trust what we've been training for the last 15 days on the grass.
Awesome. Congratulations on the appointment and good luck for the second half.
Thank you.
Mal, congratulations on the coaching appointment. Set piece has been an area of concern in the past. You must be pretty happy with that.
Yes, I am. You know, we're just starting off with the basics. If we can get our set piece right, then we can give that top quality ball to our attack, our back line. Yeah.
A lot of debutantes, but seem to be running the cutter pretty well. Hannah King, how are you making her game?
Oh, she's been awesome today. What we have to do is we've got to give her more quality ball in our forwards by setting up our pods a lot faster and giving her some more options so she can play. Yeah.
Awesome. Good luck for the next half.
Thank you.
Yeah, that is Carla Hohepper and Melanie Bosman. A 5-point advantage.
Good goal. Come on.
Against Poua running from right to left on your screen in this second half. Nicely taken by Bremner. You see the change that's been made at halfback with Ariana Baylor, and there's a nice change here. Saito away to Holmes. Looking to move, gets the ball. The Japanese international is still there, a little isolated though. Can she smuggle that ball back? No, she can't. Because Eleanor Plum King has picked off. That is outstanding work and just continues to be to the fore.
Well, we started the first half with a whole lot of action going on. And already 30 seconds into the second half, we can see the intentions and messages have obviously sunk into these players. And they're both wanting to get the upper arm in this game. The break there, great offload. And another pass there from Saitl. Find Renee Holmes into space, backs up again. Look at this, turnover straight on the ball.
There's no bodies there to help her. Bad when you can take off Hiana Tauhinu and bring on Ariana Baylor. Poua though with the ball at the moment from one of their many standouts in the first half. The vice-captain, Leila Sutton. Lush wants to come back. Atia Feretic. And coming out wide. Tofua comes back in. Side away right. And keep it close though. There's Rakato. Presents nicely, does Rachel. Say again, Tangawai this time. They take the legs out from underneath Monica. Great tackle, Anderson. That's it. Little pop ball away. Patia Fereti. King, great little short ball there away to Kotai. Harmony steps back in. One of the number of debutants. Player down there for the Poua. Oh, ball lost by...
Knock on,
Poua. Oh, and there's a player down and a bit of concern being shown as well.
Looks like captain Jackie Patia Fereti has gone down, which will be a sad sight as she went through injury-ridden last year in the competition. A couple other substitutions, though, for the Manawa. Meranea Paraone has come on. Jersey number 22 for Azalea Marka.
See the skipper. Hopefully only just maybe a little bit winded. Always busy. Looking at that right shoulder. A little bit of strapping on it. Mind you, when you are 35 years of age, playing season, what is it, 18, you're allowed to have a little bit of strapping to get you through a game.
A bit of push and shove happening off the ball as well, just earlier in the piece there. Ruby Tui was set up in the Hurricanes Poua pod, ready to receive the ball off their halfback. So she's playing games with them. Got a push in the back by Rachel Rakato.
The defending champions, Matutu versus the Blues. That's coming up next. Wonderful rugby venue, Rugby Park in Invercargill. They will be amped for that one down in the deep south. Tell you right now, if it's anything like what we're watching at the moment, they could be in for some fun and games down there. Polonavale with the game face on. Great height from both scrums. A little bit of way on. Baylor. Ball's gone backwards. Little bobble from Ariana. Gets it away to Kennedy Simon, who just drops the shoulder down. So I'm getting a little niggly down there, as Lizelda alluded to. Simple with the clearing kick. Finds a good touch midway, 22-10 metre mark. A little feisty to start the second half.
Yeah, she is a bit feisty, but look, the experience of Chelsea, Simple there. Just settling things down. Kicking to safety. Good to see Ariana Baylor back in the Chiefs Manawa jersey, wanting to really cement her spot in the squad. We've been impressed with the variation here of the Hurricanes Poua in their lineup.
Nicely taken. Wrap around and drive. And they've earned the advantage as well. Lush. Here comes a short ball. Ferris. They stop here, and they will come back and play the original.
On the arm, yeah.
Waterman looking to that left-hand corner. Touch final, they'll have about 10 metres to travel.
They've got most of the options in their lineup. Hurakato, Ferris getting up, getting clean ball. Throw's been good from Tofua. Maybe we might see a bit of a driving more here this time round.
It's nice. And they do look to try and drive.
It's down by goal, down by goal.
You hear Ben Wallerton saying it was down by the Poua.
Ball's there.
Ball's out, elbow!
Manawa go through. There's a little knock on when they had the chance. You just see the head rock back there of Kennedy Simon. Knew there was an opportunity to secure the ball and it's been missed.
Blacks up.
Well, they're throwing everything at them. Other Chiefs, Manawa defensively, some with all the expertise.
Yeah.
Charmaine Smith there. She initially has the ball, but just a slight knock on. You can see some changes coming in here, Liz.
Yep, China Hohepa has come on for Chelsea Bremner, so replacing number 5 Chelsea Bremner, China Hohepa, in jersey number 19.
So it's a great bench that Crystal Carl has got to be able to use. You've got the experience, the likes of a China Hohepa. And then you've also got the wonderful youth and exuberance of a Mirania Parani, who's also on the field at the moment too in jersey 22. This is a nice little...
Fines.
Nice toys for a coach to have.
Early.
Oh, now the Poua. That's disappointing.
Scrum. Scrum again.
Yeah, he's going to take the scrum here.
Yeah, it's
not free. It's over on that side, right in front of Ben Woolerton, I think it was. But Asik, who was called, here she is, Leilani.
Really unfortunate. The Poua, the second scrum penalty, the early push there, the perfect platform set off.
Crunch.
Once again, we see the Chiefs Manawa happy to keep ball in hand, but they've been pinned down in their own 22 for some time now.
A great angle on the scrummaging height. Chiefs with a bit of advantage here, starting to get the Poua on backwards. Wheels. Baylor. Ooh, a little bit of hesitation. Steinmetz sees some space, tries to go through. Nice open side tackle by Ferris.
Entry. No, you're never in the
game. Oh, a chance though for the Manawa to get out of dodge here. Runs up to the far side of the field. Where she found touch. Oh, she got lucky as it skips over the advertising hoardings. Struck that as well as what she would have liked.
Substitutions for the Hurricanes. Poua, 19. Number 19, Celia Marie. Poua Topoiono is coming on, replacing Leilani Parisi. Welcome back to Super Rugby, Leilani. You did your little boy proud.
Good shift. Nice little wave to the family who I'm sure are in the stands. Silly Marie.
Over.
Nice work by Patia Ferretti to get up there and disrupt a little bit. It's taking a bit of flow away. Here's Mira Anderson, who's had a really steady game. Ball sits up nicely. Steinmetz wanting to get to the outside. Nice tackle by Baker. Well presented, Steinmetz. Simple. Yeah, the call. Ball is out. Nice take down by her ankles by Galona Vale. As well, Baylor's got to get there. Looking. Get this wide. Parani. Great ball from Henwood. Looking out wide is Smith. We need to go a little in and away on Tangawai, the veteran. Just short of halfway. Poua flying in. Parani in there again. Solid hit on Kennedy Simon by Sutton. Simple. Holmes. Baker comes flying up. Great line speed coming from the visitors. Baylor. Henwood. Oh, just about stepping in there with Sturmey for the intercept.
First, then second.
And we'll go for another scrum there.
9 gold sub.
The Chiefs Manawa definitely lost a little bit of cohesion there with the change in halfback. Not quite been getting the clean ball that they were getting in the first half. But equally though, the Hurricanes Poua defensively been pushing. The D line up, meeting them at the ad line, putting all sorts of them under all sorts of pressure. Some more changes coming in, Liz.
There is. There's a lot of excitement down here because Kelsen McCook is making her Super Rugby Aupiki debut, number 21, replacing Paige Lash, who also just played her debut and had an outstanding first 48 minutes.
Fine.
7 gone in the second half, no change to the halftime score. Good scrum there from the Manawa. Another messy ball, but it sits up really nicely.
Not on ball, lost.
That's Barani running onto it at pace. Steinmetz taking on the line, gets the fend going. Rolls and presents well. Baylor, simple, and Smith combined. Smith carries, rolls and presents. Baylor blindside, short ball from Holmes. Simons presents.
Barnard's not rolling.
Simple. Again, they go to midfield. Great strong carry by Anderson.
Advantage.
More advantage again. Simple. Connor wrapping around his Mirirangi. Pull to the outside. Parani. Trying to get over the top. Ball is still there. More advantage for the home side. Slow ball though. Simple sees a little space. Tried to get him behind it. Still retain the ball though. Numbers wide here. Steinmetz. Here's an option. Tui sees space and accelerates. Ruby Tui. She's away. You cannot give her that much room. She's quicker than a hiccup and she scores.
Well, how good to have Ruby Tui back in Super Rugby. Aupiki in the Chiefs Manawa. And there wasn't a lot going on for the Chiefs Manawa. They've been jammed down the end for some time, but look at this. It's just the show and go. She gets inside Shakira Baker. The chase is on, and no one is catching the strip of red here in Ruby Tui.
I think what we're seeing too is the Manawa play a bit more direct. For the first 40-something minutes, we've seen them just try and get it to the edge, but actually having someone attack the line like Ruby just did there holds the defenders and stops the drifting.
Easy conversion for Rennie Holmes. Straight away that lead is extended out to 12.
And we've got another girl coming on, young woman coming on here, making her debut out of the Hawke's Bay. Leilani Hakiwai in jersey 23. Replaces Monica Tagaoi, who's had an outstanding game.
I've got to say, I'm a little surprised that Tangawai has been removed from the battle. There is Leilani Hakiwai, stand out for the Hawke's Bay Tui.
Right again.
A very good campaign last year in Farah Palmer Cup. Just another example of the great young talent coming through. New Zealand rugby. Here comes Parani. Oh, big solid contact. Rakato. Ball loose. Ferris swoops on it. Not for the first time in this game. Chiefs Manawa not able to exit after scoring. Great field position and an opportunity now for the Poua. Cook looking to snipe. Runs into Crystal Murray, who's come on.
She snuck on there, Crystal Murray, in number 17. She's replaced Kate Henwood.
Well, she's up against her old team. Third franchise seeing Crystal Murray now in a Chiefs Manawa jersey. No doubt they welcome her with open arms. But look, the Hurricanes Poua have really taken up the challenge in this match so far. You think of the players that they've lost in Tukura, Ngataringa Mate, Victoria Zabritsky, Napatali, Aroha Savage, Crystal Mays, the list goes on. But these young debutants that are stepping up, Hakiwai, McCook, Plum King, they're all really taking on this challenge.
Tough four with the ball held high. Nicely at the front for the skip, a little messy down though. Cook gets swarmed, someone else will have to play halfback. Messy. Ferris does it and just drops the shoulder and charges. Cook. Carried there by Olupatia. King. Baker trying to bust through. Over the top of that ball. Saito can't get it. McCook going for a wee bit of a snipe. They've got her up. There's some holes around the fringes that aren't there at the moment. King out of sight. She's going to go through that route
right
as well.
Here.
Oh, great counter drive over the top. The impact of a Crystal Murray. Done well though, the Poua. Hit down and driving. Tofaono with the carry.
No, it's not rolling.
Tofaono rolls this ball back. There's Eleanor Plum King still grafting away. And they've earned themselves a penalty.
Must roll east west.
Well, this little option is adjacent to the goals here. It's a nice 3 points for what Waterman to attempt. See the territory in position.
You've got to go east west, you're in the nine space.
Look at the territory there. Played all their rugby out their end of the field. You just need a bit of icing on that cake to get some more points up. They've kept themselves in this game really well.
Yeah, you've got to stay
really
on
the, taking
yeah.
it to the Chiefs, Manawa.
Yeah, sorry, yeah, they've called, yeah,
and now it's
yeah.
Waterman. You know her goal kicking is a real advantage for this team. She kicked at 81% last year.
If she's nice, she can.
She'll probably pop this one over with her eyes closed.
Nice and calm. And through, and that brings the lead to single digits. Still got 25 minutes to go. Look at that time in opposition 22.
Looks like another substitution for Chiefs Manawa. Victoria Edmonds in number 16 jersey. Coming on for Saina Saito, our Japanese export. Also made her debut for Chiefs Manawa and in New Zealand playing Super Rugby Aupiki.
Also highlights as well the wonderful versatility that there is in the women's game. Victoria Edmonds is quite comfortable playing hooker. She's also very comfortable playing it's loose forward, as is Saina Saito. This being able to play in the front row as well. It's a nice kick, simple back there to take it. Might they come again? Parauni, big step and away, Benadia. Still going. It takes a couple to stop her. Great work for Rakatana and Waterman. Advantage here if they can get this ball out. Now the Chiefs starting to try and accelerate. Hohepa spun in the tackle. Baylor looking, scanning, little dab over the top for Tui to chase. Oh, it sits up. There is Kotai, but it was all under advantage. Nanania Parauni making an impact.
Nanania Parauni actually started in the Chiefs Manawa as a hooker. Debuted in 2022 as a hooker. Went and spent a season in Spain in 2023 and now is back.
Four tries already.
As an outside back.
Ever thought about moving into the front row, Liz?
No, I probably shouldn't even have been a forward. Probably should have been a back anyway.
I'd expect that answer from a loose forward.
Take a look at this. Oh, big, wow. Huge step on the inside of Baker. Fends off another. This is the skill set that Merenea Parauni offers. The Chiefs Manawa, it's good to have her back on home soil. Plays her club rugby for Kihikihi. Alongside her sister, Lina Parauni, plays with the Waikato FPC team. Hugely talented sisters follow the Hohepa sisters.
Manawa taking the option here of the points. Extend that lead back out. Lovely strike, some lovely camera work just showing you the intense concentration from Rennie Holmes. Re-establishes that lead at 12, just 22 to go.
Another substitution coming for the Hurricanes, Poua, Marilyn Whanunga, number 16, replacing Denise Aiolopotia. Congratulations, Denise, debut for Hurricanes Poua, came into the squad this week just excited and grateful to be here, but she has deservedly played her part.
Yeah.
Well, it's gone over the head. I don't think Parani got her hands on it, which has been quite advantageous because they came all the way back to halfway. There is Marilyn Whanonga.
Scrum option.
Straight away, she's got to go to work in the front row. Now, we're in a really key time here for the Hurricanes Poua. When you look at last season, this was a period of the game where they conceded a lot of points. So, big ask now for the reserves. Have we seen more changes, Liz?
Yes, we have. Grace Kukutai has come on. She's making her debut for Chiefs Manawa. Packing down on the blind side, replacing Mia Anderson, and Chelsea Semple comes to the sideline, replaced by Uppy Nichols and number 23.
Five. I was doing an interview on Thursday outside the Chiefs Manawa gym, and I can tell you right now, Grace Kukutai was dragging a weighted sled on the concrete for a good 15, 20 minutes while I was there. She was absolutely putting in some yards, that lady on your screen. I've never seen anybody with a sled attached to them smiling as much. She was loving it.
We might see some positional changes here. Chelsea Semple now going off, and good to see her put out a good 60 minutes in her return to Super Rugby. Uppy Nichols is likely to slot back into fullback, and they bring Renee Holmes into first five. You see them resetting for the scrum here. How good to see Chelsea Semple there on screen. Little Cammy in the crowd watching her mum for the first time out on this field.
Centre field, great opportunity. Off the back comes Edmonds. Here is Holmes up here at first receiver. Parani going straight at Hucky White. Equal to the task was Leilani. To Smith. Poua trying to get over the top. See Ferris in there battling. Yes. Luke O'Connor just trapping Sutty there. Steinmetz to Kalonavale. Baylor getting there. Steinmetz again. Oh, that would have been an interesting ball if she'd given it to Nichols. She held on to it. They're trying to keep her up. Fling it to the ground. Can they smuggle it back?
Not
they won't need to. You got to feel sorry for Layla Say. She was trying to get out of the way there, but just Luke O'Connor said, nope, I'm just going to sit the small of your back. You're not going anywhere. Chance four. Manawa to put this ball inside the 22, they would hope. The right foot of Rennie Holmes. Done well.
So the ball makes up there.
Once again, back row is going at it. Clever play there from Luca. Kind of trapping the player in there, almost sitting on her back. In fact, Leila Say. Any more changes coming on, Liz?
Couple more to come here. We've got number 17, Tamia Edwards, making her debut for the Hurricanes Poua, replacing Christo Tofua and stalwart Rachel Rakato. Has come to the bench. She's deserved her well-earned rest for number 20, Sam Taylor.
Now, as we
sorry
move
for
this.
Kahurangi Sturmi, my apology. Kahurangi Sturmi has replaced Rachel Rakato.
Well, good, Liz. I don't blame you for getting a bit confused. There's bodies going left, right, and centre. Here comes some more coming off as well. That's Shakira Baker making way. We'll get Liz to update us as to who that is for very shortly. Up in the middle, getting there and stealing. Patia Ferretti. Nice work by the captain, but the Manawa have smuggled it back. Holmes, Steinmetz, great short ball, Edmonds. Just that ball back for Baylor. Little inside ball for Connor. She gets sat down this time. Kalonavale, little offload. It's gone forward though, as they look to get it wide.
They're sneaking onto the field, left, right, and centre. Kaelin Takitumu Cook, and number 18. But actually playing at 15 has replaced Shakira Baker.
Let's go, Marks, mate. 30 seconds, please.
She'll be a real weapon, too, for the Hurricanes Poua. great game in the preseason last week against Matatu. Great skill set to offer. Here's Kaelin Takitimu-Cook. Hurricanes giving themselves high fives all around to really shut down that attacking threat of the Chiefs, Manawa.
No.
There's McCook.
You need to hold your weight, eh?
Yeah. Well, okay. Chelsea Semple has just had a good 60-minute hit out of Super Rugby. Oh, Picky Chelsea, how's the lungs?
Oh, they've been better in the past, I'll be honest. Probably took me a little bit to shake the nerves and get back into this level of footy, but I'm pretty stoked to get through 60.
How did it feel, Chelsea, being back out there in the number 10 jersey where you started?
Yeah, some people were pretty shocked to see me in the 10, but I've played more than half my career in this jersey, so it's going to take a few games, I guess, to get back into it, but my girls have my back out there, helping me out a lot. So,
what has been the key for you to get yourself reacclimatised as the Poua win a penalty here? What has been the key for you coming back to this level?
I think, you know, after baby, she's only 6 months old, but for me it was just getting straight back in with the girls and the hub trainings. When you got Kennedy Simon and Harry Baylor and that in your hub, they make you work pretty hard. And, yeah, just getting lots of contact work in with the girls. We've had an awesome pre-season with this Manawa team, and, man, a lot of things aren't sticking for us today. I think as the season progresses, you'll see some pretty cool play. Dwayne Sweeney, our coach, has been outstanding, very innovative, so it's going to be some exciting rugby once things start to stick for us.
Well, it's great to see you back out there, Chelsea. Thanks for talking to us, and no doubt little Cammy is proud of mum today.
Cheers, Hardens. Thank you.
Yeah, great to have Chelsea Semple join us.
It's over.
Of course, Sky Sport commentator, presenter as well on occasion. Great to be able to have a chat with the players.
Tackle!
We've got just on 16 and a half to go. Just about it. Cleared bench mode for both sides. Strong carry there from Whanonga. Now Manawa trying to step over the top. Smith is in there, wrestling, grabbing. Has she dragged that ball back? Yes, she has. Charmaine Smith.
The last of the Manawa substitutions has been unleashed. Claudia Hobbs from Varsity Club gets her debut. She's been in the squad in and around about since 2022. And she finally gets her debut. Congratulations, Claudia.
Seen the impact of all these changes happening. Continuity hasn't been as clean as what we've seen in the opening 16 minutes. They start to really find themselves in the game, build their combinations, get the lungs working. But plenty of pressure still coming on from the Chiefs. Manawa is the position. Starts to lean a little bit more towards their weight. And obviously they're playing at the right end of the field.
Nicely taken by Smith as we see Taylor on for the skipper, Patia Ferretti. Oh, and the Manawa go to work. Driving over. Luka time. And straight away she's pointing at the ladies in front of her. Another try for Luka Connor and Super Rugby Aupiki, and the Manawa extend the advantage more.
What O's up for Luka Connor? O's for Aupiki, no doubt, her hometown. We know that when we see these pitches, it is so hard to stop. She's had to wait 65 minutes to get on the board, but she does exactly that. And Luka Connor, she retains the top try scorer of the Super Rugby Aupiki.
This is the thing about this Manawa Mall, is when things do start to turn ugly, when it's not as clinical and as clean as you'd like it to be, you can always revert back to this, to just settle things down and get some points on the board. And that's what they did last year, and that's what they're doing again this year.
It's an impressive strike rate that Luka Connor has. She's at better than a try a game. Renee Holmes trying to convert.
Is that benches clear, barring injuries? Yes.
Another lovely strike from Holmes. Advantage now out to 19, as there she is, the try-scoring machine, Luka Connor.
Absolute clean out of the benches today. Both teams have emptied their bench. Sam Taylor snuck on there, also debuting for the Hurricanes, Poua. across both teams. It's 13 debutants, 10 for the Hurricanes, Poua, and 3 for Manawa and Super Rugby Aupiki.
Steinmetz, who's debuting in a way. First game for the Manawa, also first in this position. Nice little inside ball. There's Edmonds on the carry.
No goal.
Baylor coming away to this right-hand side once again. There's Murray to Smith. Ball pushed back. Nichols. Nice carry there by Crystal Murray. Baylor. Kukutai, little short ball. Shortened up as well, was Edmonds in a great tackle. Steinmetz, little show, little go kicking for space. Brownie, will that set up? Yes, it will. And she stays in. Baylor wants that ball. I'm going to swing this one back to the right-hand side. Simons with the head down and charging. The Black Ferns co-captain presents beautifully. Pick and go up the middle. Here's Kukutai. She needs some support. Or does she? Still going. Looks to pop that ball, finds Steinmetz. Steinmetz over the top. Step inside Holmes, little wrap around. There's Smith. Connor, she's sniffing another try, but they go back inside. Five out. That's Ruby Tui. Luca Connor! She goes back to back, and the lead extends further.
A beautiful team try from the Chiefs, Manawa, as they really start to find their straps here. It all started from the great break from Grace Kukutai. First time we see her with ball in hand, and this is what she can do. Got a bump off there, she finds some space, looks for outsides. Doesn't quite find the support immediately, but eventually they come in the likes of Grace Steinmetz, who's been everywhere today. She continues to find out wide. They step inside from Renee Holmes. Toll do well to really throw everything at Ruby Tui. But look, just snipping away in the back there is Luca Connor. She can see the line, and she slices straight through.
I had to check with the Manawa bench if Grace Steinmetz was playing at 10. But no, she's just doing so well as a 12 to pop in when she's needed. Like you said, honey, she's all over the park. She's doing great in that transition from outside wing now in midfield.
You make a great point, Les, because her work rate when she's played on the wing has never been at fault. She's brought exactly that same attitude into second five. She's had a lot of opportunity as well as Holmes with another strike. And this one here, a rare miss today for Rennie Holmes. So the lead remains 41-17. Steinmetz, though, has been very active. This is just bread and butter for Luca. Not sure who was more excited, Luca or Charmaine Smith. Just on 8.5 to play. As you've heard Liz Elder allude to, the benches have been cleared. Now, as we speak, we see another player making their way back onto the field, so there might have been another issue. Here's Steinmetz again with another carry, trying to bust her way through. That's around about an 11th or 12th carry of this game for Grace. Spinning away, that's Nichols getting upended.
No, you're fine, I can't reward you for six, has to roll.
Unfortunate.
Going, sorry Liz, we'll get back to you because Ariana Baylor's made a really nice break here, trying to thread a needle. And that's Rakato, who I suspect Liz Elder is going to tell us very shortly, has come back onto the field. Let's stay with the play for the moment. Little kick over the top, and that ball's out on the full. They're going to have to come back. And Liz, now you can tell us the reason why Rakato's back on the field.
Yes, it's pretty hard to come off the field and you're in your 30s and then go back on, but she's done well. But sadly, she's had to replace Layla Sutton at number 8, who has gone down with an injury.
That'll be deeply concerning for the Poua, looking ahead to next Saturday, where they host the Matatu in Wellington. Nicely off the top, Baylor. Holmes, Steinmetz carrying again. Baylor loses her balance a little bit. Want to go wide, great hands over the top. There's Parani, who's been a real handful. Well, Steinmetz said we spoke earlier on in this game about how she's moved in from wing into second 5'8". We just mentioned the work rate that she's brung. She does appear to be more than happy, Honey Hitomi Smiler, to put the body on the line, Grace Steinmetz, and do a little bit of that work that you do associate with the 12 jersey.
I'm very impressed with her efforts at 12. And also just the partnership there that she's had with Marker, the connection with Holmes out the back there, who's now shifted into 10. I mean, she definitely does not look out of place.
I said, I had a chat with Grace on Thursday, and she was just talking about how whenever she walks into a room, she tries to address everybody by name. And she said that's how she feels as though she can make those connections. When you're in a system for as long as you are coming in, you need to try and do those little things. And it really does look as though she's fitted in nicely. I'm sure she'll be the first to say, oh, there's a few things I've got to work on after the game. But I think all in all, she should be pretty happy with her first run at 12.
Well, she'll be also having the back of her mind around the Black Ferns contracts. And we know that we've got Alan Bunting in the crowd here today. And he's made everyone aware that there are 13 contracts available for the Black Ferns this year. And there's plenty of games to go. So all these players are putting their hands up.
Yeah, it just adds to the excitement of Super Rugby Aupiki. Here come the four again. Not lying down. Oh, big, strong carry. That was Kahurangi Sturmi. McCook. Come away. Eleanor Plung King has just worked and worked tirelessly for the pile this afternoon. Getting the hands free. That's nice. Away to Taylor. Lost that ball forward. Just as she was looking to try and get the ball back to Sturmi again. More pumpkin and jersey six. Here's Taylor on debut.
Just inside.
Rakatau back on the field.
The handling error is starting to creep up for the Hurricanes. Poua. And some of the debutants there. They'll be disappointed with that, but look, so much skill set to offer and just the confidence to really play with this type of intensity and up against a whole lot of Black Ferns. I love the confidence that's coming through in all these debutants.
You can see the numbers just underneath the score there. We saw the carries were very similar, but a lot more metres gained by the Manawa.
We need a stable platform. Working too hard early.
Another couple of minutes to go. Chiefs Manawa with the bonus point as it stands at the moment.
Let's go.
I'm going to be heading to Bell Park in Pakaranga next week to take on the Blues.
Scrum dominance really starting
inside
to raise.
Yeah, you're inside if you want it.
It's standard for the Chiefs Manawa. And the likes of Crystal Murray up against the old team.
You see at Bell Park next week, 2 o'clock. Blues versus Chiefs Manawa. It's always a good old go, the Battle of the Bombays, Aupiki style. Here come the Manawa looking to drive 22 metres. Luca Connor smells another try, but they're going to set the backs alight. Flatball, Steinmetz, good strength to present again. Baylor, Holmes, cross kick, Parani, that is delightful.
Well, there's firepower in the forwards and in the backs, and how beautiful the kicking game was brought to fruition from Renee Holmes. See the flat ball there to Grace Steinmetz. They recycle quickly. Quick look up. She sees the space. Melania Parone, bang on the ball. And big smile from her.
Cross kick to Merenea Paraone has paid off in a couple of instances this game. And there we see it pay off in the right moments, in the right parts of the field. But an awesome return back for Merenea Paraone, who's, like I said earlier, spent a season in Spain, come back, and she's looking in the form of her life.
Very just a wipe down there as Holmes slotted into first five and made a great fist of that as well. It's probably one of the more challenging kicks of the day for Renner. That one to the left. It's 90 seconds left. That's just, it's deep. That's lovely.
Oh, it's just beautiful to watch, isn't it? Millionaire runs in the ninth try for the Chiefs. Got a double from the captain, Kennedy Simon, a double from Luke O'Connor. There's only a minute to go, but I'm not too sure they're done just yet.
Well, the crowd has enjoyed themselves. They've got vocal. Opening to the new season. A reminder, it's six rounds in the regular season. That one, Grace Diamonds won't be enjoying when they do the video review on Monday morning. Gives the Poua an opportunity to finish this game off with some points. They've contributed mightily. Never fault the effort, the tenacity, the intent of the team. In yellow and black, there's a big drive to the line. Boy, the Poua driven back though. Nice and low. Can drive once again. Great defense by the Chiefs. Manawa trying to get the Poua player on their back. Away it comes. Kaurangi Stemi, she's close to the line. Can they smuggle it back? Going again.
Hands and feet.
Going again. There's the try. They do get the final say.
That's full time.
Nonga, that's got over. Let's double check that for you.
Well, it's beautiful work here from the forwards. Plenty of attempts there. Like Tamir Edwards.
It is.
May have got over the line on. Debut, how good from out of the Hawke's Bay. The score really doesn't reflect the effort that the Hurricanes Poua have put into this game today. They've been outstanding. And they get the last say.
Nice work there by Tamir Edwards again. Another outstanding season in Farrah Palmer Cup level, stepping up. Try on debut. Caelan Takitimu-Cook taking over the kicking duties. And that is the final act of a very entertaining opening game of Super Rugby Aupiki for 2024. But it is last year's beaten finalists. The Chiefs Manawa looking to take that extra step in 2024 and get off to the perfect start. Bonus point win over the Hurricanes Poua, 46-24 in Kirikiriroa Hamilton. Happy, satisfied. Well, satisfied as you can be after the opening game, because as every coach, every player will tell you, there are always little things that will bug them from the performance. But Chiefs Manawa should be pretty pleased with that opening start.
Oh, absolutely. And just both teams, you know, you always suspect a little bit of rust when you come into these opening games. But look, I think both teams are coming in great form. They've shown real cohesion and connection there. Built some depth in terms of their recruitment, and just the opportunity for the new talent to get out there. I've offered some surprise, and it's just so good to see.
Well, they'll see the Poua, they'll be disappointed, but there will also be a fair bit of pride in that when you're putting so many debutants out on the field. They'll take a lot of positives out of it. Well, let's head down to Liz Alder and let's get some post-match comments. She's with the Chiefs Manawa captain.
Ken's, congratulations on the first win of the season. Tough 40, what'd you make of that?
Yeah, definitely very tough. Physical side, very athletic and clinical, so just needed to make sure we didn't take the foot off.
You had a new pairing in your 10 and 12. How do you think they went today, especially Grace Steinmetz there, you know, playing the full 80?
I'm really proud of them. You know, Chelsea coming back from baby and Steiny coming over into a new number. So I think they've done themselves well, and it'll just be a continuation throughout the season.
Probably not as clinical and as tidy as you would have hoped, but where do you go next week?
I think we just focus on up front tackles. You know, we've come a long way throughout our short pre-season, but I think what we'll go away and work on is just executing and not letting the ball go.
Awesome. Congratulations on the first win and a couple of meat pies. Enjoy next week.
Thanks, Liz.
By the way, just for those watching, Kennedy Simon had the black eye before she played the game, which just gives you an indication on just how intense the Manawa training has been since they've come together. Well, let's get the other side of the coin and head down, because Jackie Patia Fedetti is with Liz Elder.
Jax, the score doesn't reflect how good that game was. What did you make of that 80?
I thought the ladies done really well, especially in the first half, first part of the second half as well. But also our warriors that came on to finish the work and get that try. A lot of young players, ladies who debuted today, and it was awesome to see them get out there and have fun.
100%. 10 debutants today for the Poua. You're obviously building depth. How important is that?
I think it's really important. In the past, we've just had a lot of players, experienced players come in, but I think it's important that we start growing from around our regions.
Excellent. Big game next week. What do you do moving forward to evolve your game?
Probably just work on our one percenters, our set pieces, one-up tackles, but yeah, still proud regardless.
Excellent. Congratulations, mate. And you made it through first game. Congratulations to you too. All the best for next week.
Yeah, they host the defending champions, Matatu, next week in Wellington, while the Chiefs head to Pakaranga to take on the Blues. Great opening game of Super Rugby Aupiki 2024, but it is the Chiefs Manawa victorious 46-24 in Kirikiri Rawa Hamilton.